Today we will discuss on our MCQ post number 32, MCQ Self Challenge. In this MCQ we have covered the discussions on the startup scheme of the Government of India launched in 2016. So we will discuss in this MCQ what are the incentives available to the Startup India scheme and why the government is promoting this scheme. The innovation is the key to success for any individual as well as the country as a whole. So in this regard, our chartered accountants are also doing a lot of innovations, and to promote the innovations, the Government of India has launched a scheme called the Startup India Schemes, in which they promote the startup schemes, they promote the startups which involves innovations in the business, whether it is manufacturing, services or any area. So this is a very, very optimistic scheme. The government is very, very optimistic about these schemes. So to promote this scheme, the government is giving various incentives to the startups. The first important incentive is like, where did they get the finance? So government is providing the very lucrative finance facilities to the startup businessmen. And the second important thing is ease of doing business. So there are a lot of complexities in starting the business, the labor laws, the pollution control, the environmental appearances and Apprentice Act and all those things. The government is also providing a lot of incentives or a lot of facilities to these startup organized businesses. So this startup businesses, the government has divided this compliance into two parts. One is something which is eligible startup and for the eligible business. So eligible startup is basically a startup which starts the incorporated on or after 1st of April 2016 and before 31st March 2021. So this is the first basic condition, and the second basic condition, this eligible startup should do an eligible business. So this eligible business is basically defined in the schemes itself or in the Income Tax Act under section 80 IAC, in the explanation of 80 IAC. So basically any business which is involved innovations in the field of product development, service processes, and which are also generating a lot of employment is covered under this eligible businesses. So the eligible startup doing the eligible businesses may be entitled for non-tax incentives and tax incentives. So first the non-tax incentives is basically the providing them the finance at the lower cost, and all type of they are also self certification schemes for the startup with for the environmental clearances for other products like Apprenticeship Act or under labor laws, under six labor laws. So for the 1 year they don't have to do any compliances. The government has made it very easy for the startup to start the businesses and also providing the finance facilities. The tax incentives, the government has planned three type of tax incentives for this startup. So first is the tax rebate to the startup, and second is generating income in the hands of the startup. So that there are three steps the government is taking so that the startup can get money, because it's a long duration gestation products. So the first important benefit is section 80 IAC, under which there is a 100% tax deduction for an eligible startup for the three consecutive years out of the seven 7 years from the incorporation of this startup till the year 31st March 2021. So this is very, very important provision which provides the 100% exemptions on the profit of the tax exemptions on the profit of the startup. And the second important part to generate the income or the capital in their hands, there is another section under section 100 and under section 54 double E. This startup is eligible to invest in a capital assets, in a capital assets on their long term capital gain they are arising out of their business. So this exemption is available up to 50 lakhs in a year to this startup. And at the same time the individual who would like to start their startup, so there is another section 54GB under which an individual and HUF is eligible for a deduction if they sell their residential house property, long term residential house property. This is just like a deduction under section 54F, where a assessee selling his residential property and utilizing this money for the startup businesses. So same terms and conditions are there, like this deduction is available to individual NHUF. Number two, for selling their individual house property, for residential house property. And if the residential house property, the consideration will be utilized for their startup businesses, and that startup businesses will use this particular amount for purchasing of the assets for these startup businesses. So they are, the same conditions are there which are there under section 54. This is a very, very, very lucrative provisions to attract the startup for selling their residential property and invest into their startup to create their innovations. So this is another provision. The another provision under the Income Tax Act is under section 56, where any startup is selling their shares at a value higher than the FMB, they will get this section 56 will not attract on this particular provision if the fair market value of the investment is more than what is the book value, or the investment value is more than whatever the fair market value of the investment. So there are a lot of incentives the government is providing to promote this startup schemes. So lot of convenience is being provided to the startup. So this startup is going to grow. There are thousands of startups has been initiated. We at a chartered accountant is also starting certain startups, and we can also be a good business advisor for the startups because we know the provisions at length. So thank you so much for the startups. Thank you.